worship with us. Why don't you put your hands together? Come on.
Come on, somebody. My name is Kevin. This is Megan. We're the lead pastors of Trove Heights here. Obviously, a brand new church. Thank you for being here on day Number one, this is a dream that literally is 2 years in the making, and thank you for being a part of it. We've been praying for you and dreaming about you for 2 years, and it's happening. It's here, everybody. We're here. Come on.
Yes. 2 years ago, we were sitting around a kitchen table, and we were signing bylaws, and that's so fun to do, signing bylaws and stuff. But we were talking about our vision. What's that going to look like? And we were just dreaming about this day. Yeah. And, you know, we couldn't see what it was going to look like, but God saw it, and he saw you here. So we're just so excited that you've joined us today.
Yeah, man, this is crazy. You're literally an answer to prayer. This is a miracle. And I can't believe it, because this journey started, and we moved here at the beginning of May last year in the height of COVID. And my pastor back home, Pastor Jeremy Foster, he was like, it's time to go. I was like, I don't know if that's God. It's COVID is happening, you know? And just to watch God's faithfulness every step of the way, look what the Lord has done. I can't believe it. I can't believe it. And that's enough about us. And look, our team has prepared a great experience for you. Where's my dream team in the room? Come on, dream team. Get the dream team in the room. Look, we've done our best to prepare a great experience for you. We tried to think of everything it would take to make sure that you have an opportunity to experience the power and presence of God today. That's why we're here. Now, if you got questions about anything, you need to know where something is, you can find one of our team members with a yellow lanyard. They'll be able to help you answer any questions that you have, find the restrooms, kids, coffee, any of that, they can help you. But enough about us. Today is all about you experiencing the power and presence of God. That's it. I don't know about y'all, but I'm here to experience the power and presence of God. Anybody else here for that? That's why I'm here. And so we're going to go back into worship. As we do that, I want to encourage you, don't worry about who's on your left and who's on your right. God has a moment for you today if you just tap in. I'm going to pray for us. We're going to go back into worship, and I encourage you to worship with everything that you have today, all right? Let's pray about it. God, we love you. We thank you for all that you're going to do here today. Thank you that we get to be in this room for this time, this place, such a time as this. Today we need you. We give you our full attention. Give you all of us today. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Everybody said, amen. Come on, let's worship together.
Can we just press into the presence of God that's here? Jesus is so eager to meet us here today. Jesus, we've just come to worship your name. Such a beautiful name, such a powerful name. Can we all just lean in a little bit to his presence?
Hidden glory in creation. Now realize.
doing that all day right there. Man, I'm telling you what, listen, this is just, this is literally a dream come true for us, a miracle. But it's all about a moment in the presence of God. That's what this is about. We don't want to put on a show. We're not trying to impress anybody. I'm trying to just do this for the one, for the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. I want him to get glory. That's why we're doing this. And as we've been preparing for this now for, God, 2 years, and had to push our launch day back, supposed to do this in January. And needless to say, couldn't find a venue that would open for us in the middle of all the restrictions at the time with COVID and everything happening. And so many doubts and opportunities to say, God, did I really hear from you? Plenty of moments of doubt and fear and worry. And here we are, we've been leading up. Just so you know, we've been in a season of 21 days of prayer and fasting. Today's day 22, it's gonna be prayer and feasting. Come on, somebody, okay? We've been praying and fasting just for you. We touched every seat that you're sitting in and we pray just for you. Because we believe this can be a life-changing moment for you. But I don't know what you came in here with. And maybe you came in here, new season. I don't know what to do. God, I'm fearful. I've been reading the book of Joshua leading up, trying to do something brand new, take territory for the kingdom of God. There is fear. And it tries to creep in at all times, but I just got to stay locked into Jesus. And you see in Joshua chapter 1, you see Joshua, the first thing that happens in the book of Joshua, God says, Joshua, Moses, my servant, is dead. Your turn. Whoo, what? I don't know what I would have done. I'd have been scared. I'd have had some doubt, some worry. But you see God over and over again tell him, hey, be strong and courageous. Don't be afraid. Be strong and courageous. He has to tell him over and over and over again. I felt like that a lot in this last season. Just be strong and courageous. Okay, God, be strong and courageous. You fast forward into chapter 3. They know they're going to the promised land. By the way, God has a promised land for each and every one of us today. But sometimes we can't see it. We got to get past Jericho first. But before I can ever even get to Jericho, I got this river in front of me, the Jordan River. They're coming up to this river. It's a mile wide. It's harvest season, so it's at flood stage. It's a raging river. God, how are we going to get to the promised land, much less Jericho, if we can't even get across this thing? And you see, God tell Joshua in chapter 3, I love this so much, y'all. This has been hammering me this week. Because for us, we did all this work and marketing to get to this point. God, what are you going to do? I don't know. But I love how he says this to Joshua. He gives him one command. He says, I want you to tell the priest carrying the Ark of the Covenant. I want you to tell him to walk up, step into the water, and stand still. End of command. That's it. Hold up, God, wait. That doesn't make any sense. What's after that? Step into the water and stand still. Joshua immediately, I mean, next verse, turns around and he's like, hey, you, John, Jeff, Bobby, come on. Come on, Megan, let's go. He says, this is what I need you to do. God said to step into the water. And as soon as your foot touches the water is gonna part, it's gonna pile up in a heap on the left and the right, and we're gonna walk through on dry ground to go take our promised land. Now check it out. God didn't tell him any of that. God said, just step in the water. And I hope this is for somebody else, because it was for me. I believe that if you just take and do what God told you to do and you just step in the water and you declare in faith that God can do more than you ask or imagine, that he can do it for you, all you gotta do is step in and watch what God does today. If anybody believes he can do it again, can you give him some praise in this place? Come on, praise him like you know it. Praise him like you mean it. Praise him like he's the God of all creation. I'm not even preaching yet, y'all. Come on, stop. Y'all give it up for Trove Heights Worship. Aren't they awesome? I got my man Ramal back here on the guitar. I was watching. He was over here. He was just worshiping from the guitar. I'm like, I want to be just like him when I grow up. Oh, man, if we've never met, my name is Kevin. I'm the lead pastor along with my wife, Megan. You heard her. She was singing on that last song. We've done our best to create an experience for you where you can tap in to the presence of God and experience the power of God in your own life. And there's a lot happening. I know it's a new place, new people, new stuff. What's going on here? But I just wanted to let you know that we've done our best to prepare it all for you. Again, find somebody with a yellow lanyard on if you have questions. Our team can help you. I believe today can spark something brand new in your life. That's our prayer for you. That's our hope today. If you got kids, you can utilize Trove Heights Kids. We got a great team back there, ready to give them their own tailored worship experience, and so you can utilize that. But we're gonna jump into the Word and the news here in a second so you can find out what's happening around Trove Heights a lot in the weeks and months ahead. But before we do that, if you're comfortable with it, get out of your area, take about 30 seconds, hug somebody, high five, blow them a kiss if it makes sense now, okay? Tell them glad to see them in church.
Heights family. My name is Megan, and I serve as the lead pastor here at Trove Heights. We are so glad you're here for Launch Sunday. There's a lot happening in the weeks ahead that you need to know about. Here at Trove Heights, we want you to dream big, search deep, find more, and live a rich life with Jesus. When you came in the door today, you received a Connect card. We want to ask you to take a moment during the service to fill that out with as much information as you'd like us to have. We would love to connect with you about all of the exciting things ahead at Trove Heights. We promise it's a safe card to fill out, and we give you our hassle-free guarantee. We want to help you connect to community and find new family here at Trove Heights. If you have kids, then Trove Heights Kids is an incredible environment created just for them to be able to worship God and have a lot of fun in their own tailored worship experience. We have Trove Heights Kids available for all ages, 6 weeks to fifth grade. Trove Heights Kids is a fun, clean, and safe environment with world-class volunteers that are ready to give your kids the best Sunday possible. Moms, we also have a mother's room if you need a quiet place to break away with your little one. Here at Trove Heights, we are a church of small groups. We believe that life change happens in the context of relationships, and we want to help you search deep in your faith journey through small groups. We have a free market approach to small groups, meaning you can build your group around the things you enjoy, whether you enjoy basketball, Bible studies, game nights, or hanging at a local coffee shop. There's a group for you. If you're interested in leading or hosting a small group, then join us next Sunday, August 29th, for small group leader training. This will take place after the service, and we will make sure you have everything you need to be equipped and ready to start your group. Our fall small groups kick off on September 12th. We are so glad you're here with us on Launch Sunday, and we believe that Trove Heights is where you belong. We are so much better with you here. Stay tuned for all the exciting things ahead, and together, let's dream big, search deep, find more, and live rich. Welcome to Trove Heights.
Come on, let's give God some praise this morning if you're glad to be in church. Anybody glad to be in church on a Sunday? Man, I'm glad to be in church. Man, this journey for us has been crazy. We moved to plant a church, and it started online. And your boy got really good at preaching to a room with nobody but a camera. Today, I'm really grateful for it because I told our team the last 3 weeks we've been in here. I've just been preaching, doing the whole message, the whole service, everything. I was like, there's going to be people in the room. I'm going to preach a whole different way. I don't care how many people are in the room. It's going to be good. So we're going to have a good time today. Anybody believe church should be fun? I believe church should be enjoyed, not endured. We're going to have a good time today. I promise that. And I believe that God brought you here for such a time as this, that you can have a moment right there where you are with the presence of God. That's our hope for you today. And I hope you also understand one thing. I know the first thing you're going to ask is, like, where'd the name come from? What's this church all about? There's a few things you got to know. Trove Heights, we are a Holy Spirit-filled, Holy Spirit-led church. We believe the whole Bible, nothing but the Bible. Nothing needs to be added or taken away. We are a full gospel, full Bible-believing church. You got to know that up front. And we're a church that loves diversity. As you can see by our team, look, we didn't do anything. God just organically brought a bunch of people together. Because when we first moved into the city last May and we started talking to people, one of the themes that we heard was diversity doesn't exist in churches in Nashville. And I thought, well, I'm not going to just sit back and just say that's what it is. I believe God can do anything, and I don't care where it's at or what's happened before now. And so we're watching God do that. It's incredible. Thank you all for being a part. I look around the room, and I'm like, this is what heaven looks like, I think. It's amazing. I love it. So we're a church that values diversity, and we value the next generation. I have two boys. They're 10 and 8, and they're crazy. But they're crazy back there at Trove Heights Kids right now, okay? Trove Heights Kids, we've got a great team back there, man. They're ready for your kids, and they're going to get a little treat on the way out today. Excited about that. So will you surprise them? Anybody like surprises? Come on. Got some surprises for you. We're going to have a good time today. But again, if we haven't met, my name is Kevin. I'm the lead pastor here along with my wife, Megan. We have been preparing for this day for a long time. And as I was getting ready to roll into today, I thought this is the start of our journey as pastors and church planners. This is the start. And this is also an opportunity for you to have a start of a brand new life with Jesus. And that's what I'm more excited about than anything. I'll go ahead and tell you right now, last service at 9:30, 9 people said yes to Jesus. Come on, somebody. It just fires me up. That's what it's all about. So I'm excited to see what God does here in this service today. And we're just going to dive right into the Word. Anybody love the Word of God? Love the Word of God, anybody? I'm excited to just dive into this with you. And go ahead and look at your neighbor on your left and tell them the message title. Say, let's get rich. Let's get rich. Now look at the one on your right, your second choice, okay? Tell them I like you too. Let's get rich. I'm gonna give all this to you out of scripture today, okay? Because I know a lot of people in a lot of our marketing, we had a lot of that and we got messages. What does that mean? Prosperity gospel. It's not prosperity gospel. I'm gonna give everything to you out of the word of God and out of the Bible and give you scripture because I believe that God wants you to live a rich life. God wants you to live a full life. You may be empty, depleted, broken down, beaten up when you walked in the door. I don't know what your world looks like, but I believe that God can give you more and greater today. I believe it can start today. And that's our hope for you at Trove Heights. And we want to walk through what that looks like. So today I'm just going to give you the vision of the church. Where'd you come up with the name? Well, I'll tell you. So Trove is another word for treasure. It means to discover or find. Years ago in my life, I found the treasure of a relationship with Jesus. Anybody else found that treasure in your life? I found that treasure and I was determined to do whatever it takes to help other people find that treasure. Because everybody wants what we have, but they don't know how to find it. So they go searching for it in all the wrong places and everything the world has to offer. We want to help them find the real treasure that they're searching for and point them in the right direction. That's what we're going to do. So Trove Heights, we thought, I know. One day we're sitting around the table. I said it like this. My pastor, Pastor Jeremy Foster, back at Hope City in Houston, we're sitting there with him. He's guiding us along to get ready to plant the church. He said, we need to come up with a name for the church. And I said, I got one. Oh, yeah, I got one. And he said, yeah, what is that? I said, it's the treasure house. Woo, it's the treasure house. And he looked at me like this. He said, bro, that sounds like a strip club. I said, we ain't gonna call it the treasure house. That ain't happening. So I went home, I told my wife and my family, I said, we gotta have a new name. We just started getting to the drawing board. What can we call it? Because treasure was a big deal. It's part of our story. Like I found the treasure. And so we found the word trove and my wife loved the word trove. So as it started clicking, we thought, the greater the treasure you find happens from the higher the heights you go. So we said it like this, the higher the heights you go with Jesus, the greater the treasure you'll find. Trove Heights, woo, that's it. It was like, that's it, amen. And he said it in the back, let's go. And it's funny because so many people around the city, we meet people and they're like, what part of town is that? They think it's an area of town. I love that because let me tell you, our vision, I don't care what I see right here. Our vision is we're going to go all over the place and give people the good news of Jesus Christ. And we wanted it to be something that could be anywhere. So that was our hope, Trove Heights. We want to help you find the treasure. We want to help you live a rich life. Maybe you're in here today and you're like, bro, you're talking about riches. I am broke. Anybody broke? Nobody's raising their hand. Oh, some of y'all did raise your hand. Y'all are like, please, y'all giving out money? No, we ain't giving out no money. We want to live a rich life. I love these memes. These are so great to me. I went down a rabbit trail. Maybe this is y'all. Me, I want to take a trip. Bank account. I highly suggest that be a trip to work. How many of y'all, that's it? You need to go to work, bro. That's where you need to go. How about this one? I'm on a new diet. It's called I Have $10 Till Next Friday. How many of y'all on that diet right now? I've been on that diet before. This one's so good. I love this one right here. Check this out. How can I transfer money that is in my mind to my bank account? God, please. I was praying that prayer last night right there when I went to bed. Now, y'all need to get real with yourself, some of you. I'm not regular broke. I'm high class broke. I'm broke. Hey, no, you broke. Y'all need to get it together. We're broke, okay? And the last one's my favorite. Listen, if you don't want to be broke, you can't be broke if you don't check your bank account. There you go. You're welcome. Just don't look at it. You'll be okay today, all right? Now listen, as funny as all that is, I'm serious. A lot of us want to live a rich life. And I'm not talking about monetary riches and gain. I'd love to drive a yellow Lamborghini. I still believe when I get to heaven, that's what's gonna happen. I don't know if that's biblical, but we'll see. I think a lot of it is determined by how you are dreaming, how you're believing, how you're praying, how's your faith. I'm not saying just name it and claim it and God's gonna give it to you. I'm not saying any of that. Again, we're gonna look at everything in scripture. But when I'm talking about a rich life, I mean, so many of us are empty. We're broken. Life has beat us up, spit us up, chewed us out, however you say that. You know what I'm talking about. God, I need you. I don't know what to do. I can't even talk straight. I'm so broke right now, God. I'm too broke to pay attention, God. I can't pay nothing. I just want to live a rich life. I want all the things that scripture talks about because we all want love and joy and peace and kindness and comfort and strength. And all that only comes from Jesus. And we know that. So we got to help people do whatever it takes to find it. I love the way this guy, Brother Lawrence, says it in a book called The Practice of the Presence of God. I would encourage you to check this book out if you've never heard of it. The Practice of the Presence of God. He says it like this. Now, this was written in the 1500s. When I read this book, I'm like, that dude is a really good Christian. He challenges my faith. The dude is deep. He says this, how happy we would be if we could find the treasure of which the gospel speaks. all else would be as nothing. As it is boundless, the more you search for it, the greater the riches you will find. Let us search unceasingly and let us not stop until we have found it. Our goal at Trove Heights is for you to begin to go on a search to find more of Jesus. Because I can't give you anything great on a Sunday morning. I might be able to say something where you go, well, that's good, preacher. Amen. You can shout it down. Preach, white boy, whatever you want to say. I'm good with all that. But that's not going to change your life. We are not here to impress anybody. We want to give you stuff that will change and transform your life. That's our goal today. So we're going to look at that out of Scripture. This is the way it says it in John 10:10. I love the NLT. That's what I've been reading this year is the NLT. These are Jesus' words, okay? He says, it starts this way. I love this verse so much. And there's a semicolon in the middle, and I love this. The thief's purpose is to steal, kill, and destroy. Man, I'm so glad that it didn't stay right there. Right behind that, this is Jesus talking. My purpose is to give them a rich and satisfying life. Maybe you walked in here today and the enemy has stolen everything from you to the point where you don't even have, I don't know if I got it. My faith is hanging on by a thread. Well, I got good news for you today. Today you are in the right place. Jesus is in the room and he can help fix every bit of your issues today. We just want to help take you on that journey because his purpose, the thief has a purpose for you and so does Jesus. And we want to help you begin to take that path. It is all determined by the search that you go on. Proverbs 10:22 says this, the blessing of the Lord makes rich, and he adds no sorrow with it. The blessing of the Lord will make you rich. Now, what kind of riches are we talking about? I love the way that the pastor, great prophet, cardinal, Pastor Biggie Small said it. He said it in a way that will let you know it doesn't just happen overnight. It's a journey. You got to go on a process, okay? Pastor Biggie, he told us how we can live a rich life or how you can go from nothing to something, all right? He said it like this. I love it so much. All right, these are wise words from Pastor Biggie. He said, Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis. When I was dead broke, man, I couldn't picture this. 50-inch screen, money, green leather sofa. Got 2 rides, a limousine with a chauffeur. Phone bill about 2 G's flat. No need to worry, my accountant handles that. And my whole crew is lounging, celebrating every day. No more public housing. Thinking back on my one-room shack. Now my mom pimps her act with minks on her back. Hey, y'all don't know nothing about that. And if you don't know, now you know. Hey, no, don't do that. Y'all stop that. This is church. Y'all stop. Production team up there acting crazy, y'all. Pastor Biggie. Now look, Pastor Biggie was my pastor in my past life. Okay, he ain't my pastor no more. I'm just saying that. But Pastor Biggie told us it didn't just stop. It didn't just all of a sudden one day he woke up and he's like, I got it. Man, y'all stop that right now, bro. Y'all quit that. Stop that, man. That's. I don't know what they're doing up here, but this is church, y'all, if y'all forgot. This is church, okay? Listen, Pastor Biggie told us, he said, listen, it's a progress. It's a progress. It's a journey. It doesn't just happen overnight. And this is the problem, that last line. Thinking back on my one-room shack, now my mom pimps an act with minks on her back. Now look, that's an Acura for those of you that don't know. An act is that's a whole other thing for you right there, okay? But the problem is too many of us are living in the one-room shack. God did not call you to live in a spiritual one-room shack. God calls you to live in a mansion spiritually and live a rich life with Jesus. But the problem is we're so stuck in that and we're rather than thinking back, we're living in it. And God's saying, I've been asking you to go. I've been opening doors. God is waiting on you to push the door open. It's time to move. He's got greater for you today. Psalms 92 says it this way, the righteous flourish like the palm tree and grow like a cedar in Lebanon. They're planted in the house of the Lord. And because they're planted in the house of the Lord, they flourish in the courts of our God. You want to live a rich life? It's determined by where you're planted. Listen, if you're planted in the club on Saturday night, I'm just saying you will not flourish and live a rich life with Jesus. It's not going to happen. You will be the sum of the 5 closest people in your life. So if everybody in your life is broke monetarily, you're going to be broke monetarily probably. If everybody in your life is an alcoholic, more than likely you're going to be an alcoholic. But today you have an opportunity to say, God, I'm going to take a new step in the right direction, and I believe that you will change everything. You have an opportunity for that today. And we want to help you with what that looks like. A rich life with Jesus all starts with this, the way we dream. So today, the first thing you need to know, take notes because I believe that you're 76% more likely to go to heaven if you take notes than if you don't. That is not biblical, but we should take notes, okay? The first thing we want you to do is dream big. We want you to dream big. That's how we want to start. And that's what our Sunday experience is made for. From the moment you walked in the door to worship, to me stepping up here and presenting the word of God to you, we want to help give you an experience that you walk out and you go, wow, God's good. God's bigger. He can do more. He's greater. That's our goal for you here today. So I'd write this down too. Your expectation determines your experience. Your expectation determines your experience. If you walked in here and you're standing there in the first song and you go, I don't like this song. That guy singing is not good. Yeah, DA, I see you in the back. That boy, he can't sing. Oh, come on. But if you're critiquing everything, that's going to be the experience that you probably have. But if you walk in and you go, God, I'm just broken. I'm in need of a Savior. He will meet you right there every single time. There's one thing that is guaranteed. If you open up and ask God to come in, he will come in. It says so in James 4:8. Draw near to God and he'll draw near unto you. But first, you got to draw near unto God. It starts with the way you're dreaming. So around Trove Heights, we say it like this. We believe he's an Ephesians 3:20 God. I believe he can do more. And that's what it says in the Message version. God can do anything, you know, far more than you could ever imagine or guess or request in your wildest dreams. So I want to ask you today, how are you dreaming? How are you imagining? How's your imagination today? I'm reading a book right now called The Circle Maker by a guy named Mark Batterson. Anybody ever heard of that, The Circle Maker? If you never had, I'm telling you, read that. It will wreck you. I'm praying a different way. Again, we've been praying, fasting for 21 days. I've been locked into this book. And he talks about how when we're younger, we're in the right side of our brain, the right brain. And that is where imagination and dreams and all the what ifs and what could be, that's where it comes from. So that's why when I was a kid, I'd say stuff like, I'm gonna dunk on Shaq when I get to the NBA. And God said, no, you ain't, you 6 foot. I was like, all right, cool. And the older I got, I'm still going to make it. By the time I got out of high school, I was like, I ain't going to make it. All of a sudden, I moved to the left brain, which is logic. So you go from imagination and dreaming to logic. The problem is too many of us go into our prayer life praying out of logic rather than imagination and faith. And I'm telling you, listen, if you pray out of logic, that's okay. God will answer your prayers and he will listen to you. But you will get maybe what you pray for and maybe what you don't. I don't know what you need. I'm not saying you say, God, just give me $1 million and it's gonna happen. That's not what I'm saying at all. But I'm telling you, if you ask God for more peace, he'll give you more peace. In the midst of your mess, God will give you peace. But if you're just in your mess and you're like, Lord, just please let me get through this mess. No, I'm gonna pray, God, get me through this mess and then take it and turn it into a message that gets somebody else out of their mess. Do something that gives you glory and gives you honor and praise. God will do it. But it starts with the way that we're dreaming. I love the way kids dream. Jesus, I love how he put it in scripture. He says, you need faith like children. He pointed to children because they imagine, they dream. I love the way these kids imagine. This imagination's amazing. I got two kids. Check this out. So this kid's in school. My dog is a hero companion worker. This kid said, my dog is a circle because he is round. That's an amazing imagination. I love kids, the way they think, right? Because to me, I'm like, that's not it. Name each angle. All right, that's Sally. That's Bob, that's Olivia. That's an A+, stamp that right there. That was me in school, your boy was not good at math. This is probably my favorite one right here. Check this out. Usually she's getting angry, you felt that feeling too. Describe a time when you felt really angry. This kid said, when I found this homework in my backpack. What did you do? I did it, leave me alone. I did the homework, I didn't want to F, okay? Imagination, I got kids that are 10 and 8, man. They think mom and dad got all the money in the world. We're like, kids, we're church planters. We need some help. But they imagine just, can we do this? Can we go here? Can we do this? Anybody ever heard of a yes day? Parents in the room, a yes day? If you're not a parent yet and you're gonna be, just squash that before it ever starts, okay? A yes day are where you tell your kids yes to everything. Be careful, okay? But what if we went to God with the approach of today's yes day? What if we went to God with the approach of, God, I know you can do it. And even if you don't, I'm okay with that. Because it's not about Jesus giving you what you want. It's about Jesus giving you more of Jesus. You get more of Jesus, you'll get more of what Jesus brings. So I need to tap into the source. And so that's what I got to know today, is that the source will determine what I get or don't get. If my source is the club, that's what you're going to get. If my source is Jesus, oh man, just endless, boundless riches. You got to search. It starts with the way you dream. I love in Matthew chapter 13, Jesus rolls up into his hometown and he's preaching. He's in the synagogues. He's doing what I'm doing right here. And then these miracles are happening. People roll up and it says that they are amazed. They're like, wow, who's this guy? Where did he get all this knowledge? Where did he get this? How's he doing that? And then all of a sudden, somebody in the crowd points out and says, wait a second. Isn't that Joe's son? Joe the carpenter? Yeah, that's it. Oh yeah, that is. That's Jesus the carpenter. I said, yeah, I know his brother. I know his mom. I know. Oh, yeah, that's it. And then they go to a point where it says they took offense at him. So then this is where we pick up in verse 58. Jesus says, a prophet is not without honor except in his own town and in his own home. And he did not do many miracles there because of their lack of faith. You can look at Jesus as if he's a carpenter and he can build you a house. Or you can look at him as if he's the God of all creation and he can change your entire world today. But it's all determined by how are you looking at Jesus? How are you searching? Because your search will determine what you find. And that's what we want to dive into today. Your expectations determine your experience. So I want to help you with this today on launch Sunday of Trove Heights. This is going to be my every Sunday goal. Our team, the goal is that you come in and you taste and see that the Lord, he is good. Anybody ever taste and see that the Lord is good? Anybody? The Lord is so good. Come on, God is good all the time and? That's all the church people right there. God is good all the time. I got to taste and see. Sometimes we're just tasting the wrong things. Taste and see that the Lord, he is good. My goal for you today is that you just taste a little Jesus. I don't have to say all the right things and do all the right things. You're not going to remember nothing I say, but you will remember what you felt in the room. And if Jesus is in the room, oh, you're going to want more of that. How can I taste that again? How can I get that again? That is our goal for you here today. We want to help you be able to taste and see that the Lord is good. The problem is too many of us are tasting all the wrong things over and over and over again. How many of y'all believe sin is fun? Honey, get the kids. What kind of church are we at? No. Look, sin is fun because if you don't believe so, you didn't do it right. Your boy did it right. I did a lot of it. I did it well. But then I tasted and saw that the Lord is good and I realized, oh, I don't want that anymore. I want Jesus. I want Jesus. The problem is I grew up in a place where it was, don't do this. Stop doing that. Bad, 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 bad. Versus somebody saying, oh, you think that's good? Let me show you what I got. Come here, let me show you what I got. Then when I tasted and saw, oh, everything changed in that moment. I tasted and saw that the Lord was good and it began to make me dream bigger dreams. And if I can pique your interest and imagination, then I think you'll go on the journey with us. That's my hope today. So you gotta know that first, you gotta dream big. Second is you gotta search deep. Our process to help you live a rich life with Jesus at Trove Heights is to take you on a journey to search deep. We wanna take you on a journey. This is not an arrival. You don't meet Jesus and arrive. There's no pinnacle with Jesus, y'all. There's no pinnacle with Jesus. Bless you. There's no pinnacle with Jesus. There's always more. Matthew 6:33 says this, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness and all of these things will be added to you. I grew up saying, seek first the kingdom of God and all these things will be added to you. But it says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Very important piece. Hebrews says that without holiness, no one will see the Lord. If I'm not living a holy, a rich, holy, righteous life, nobody's gonna see Jesus. They're gonna see Kevin. I don't want them to see Kevin. I want them to see Jesus. Jesus is the best thing that I can offer you. 1 Chronicles 16:11 says, seek the Lord and his strength. Seek his presence continually. Our goal for you here is to seek more of Jesus every day of your life. So today I'm gonna give you a 7-day challenge and I pray that you take it and run with it. I feel like the best thing I can do for you on the first Sunday of Trove Heights that you walk in and you're checking this new church out is I wanna challenge you. And I believe if you take this challenge and you come back in next Sunday, your life will be better than it was when you walked in today, okay? We believe three things are how you search deep with Jesus. You have to read the word every day, y'all. You gotta read the Bible every day. Matter of fact, if you don't have a Bible, our team has Bibles out there for you. You can grab one on the way out. They're yours. Go grab a Bible. You need the Word of God because faith comes by hearing and hearing by the Word of God, it says in Romans 10. It doesn't say faith comes by hearing and hearing Pastor Kevin Lucas. Faith doesn't come by hearing and hearing from your mom who's the church mother or hearing Bishop T.D. Jakes. All that is great, but if you are not having your own revelation in the Word with your time with Jesus, all you're hearing is some words from me. You need revelation in the Word. And then you supplement your faith, as Scripture says, with Bishop T.D. Jakes, and you get ready, get ready, get ready. And it gets bigger and better and more bold because you begin to supplement. But it starts with how are you searching the Word of God? So we call it the first 15. You need 5 minutes in the Word every single day. 5 minutes in the Word every day. Then you need 5 minutes in prayer every day. If you wonder what Trove Heights is all about, let me tell you, this is a pray first culture. We believe that prayer is our first response. It's not our last resort. We will not do it if God is not in it. We were determined we will not launch this church without prayer and fasting. So from January of 2020, we sat around my parents' kitchen table, coming up with vision statements and what's the name of the church and all this. We started in January of 2020. We dedicated the first 3 days of every month to prayer and fasting for you and for this church. And then when we came into August, we rolled in August 1st through the 21st, and we were like, we're gonna pray and fast and ask God to do what only He can do. Because I only got so much power in me, it ain't enough. I can't do it without Jesus. The problem is we try to go conquer the world and we try to live a rich life, and we can't do it without Jesus. We need more of God, so you gotta pray. I love how it says it in Colossians 4:2. Devote yourselves to prayer with an alert mind and thankful heart. If you're like, I don't know what to pray for, pray for what you're thankful for. Half the time my prayer is, I don't know what to pray. God, thank you. God, thank you that you saved me. God, thank you that you changed my life. Thank you for what you have given me. God, I am more blessed than 90% of the world. Thank you for what you've done for me. It's really hard to start your day on a bad foot when you start the day like that. And then you move into worship. You need 5 minutes in worship. So the first 15 is what we'll call this. This is the 7-day challenge for you. 5 minutes in prayer, 5 minutes in the word, 5 minutes in worship. You do that for 7 days, and I guarantee you, you walk in here next Sunday, your life will be better than it was when you walked in today. I guarantee you. I guarantee you. I love the story in Acts chapter 16. You see, Paul and Silas, they're in prison at midnight. The worst of the worst, the darkest of the dark. I don't know what your situation is. Maybe you feel like that. Maybe you feel like you're in a mind prison and it's dark. I don't know what to do. Do what Paul and Silas did. You see them right here in Acts chapter 16. It says, about midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God. Now, I don't know about y'all, but I can't say that I'd be praying and singing hymns to God at midnight in prison. But that's exactly what they do. Then it goes on to say that the other prisoners started listening to them, and suddenly there was such a violent earthquake that the foundations of the prison were shaken. And it goes on to say that all the prisoners came out and the jailer was about to take his own life. Paul said, no, don't do that. We're all here. We're all here. They come gather around and he leads the jailer to Jesus. Then the jailer, who was trying to kill them in the first place and take them out of this world, the jailer then takes him to his house, sits him at the table, clothes him, feeds him. The whole family comes to know Jesus. Unbelievable miracle, but it started with praying and praising and singing hymns to God in the midst of the worst situation of pain. And what I love about it is that God took the thing that was trying to kill them to turn around and then feed them and make them better. Come on, God can do that for you if you just tap into this. So the first 15, you need to pray, you need to read the word, and you need to worship. First 15, if you draw near to God, he'll draw near to you. This is a guarantee in scripture, James 4. Draw near to God, he'll draw near unto you. That is the best thing I can give you today. I don't want to give you some good lines. I want to give you what you need to go implement in your life on a Monday and watch God do what only He can do. So I want to encourage you to take the first 15 with me this week. That's the 7-day challenge, all right? And then as you do that, the third thing in our vision is going to begin to happen for you. You will find more. You will find more. If you search, you will find. The more you seek, the more you find. Good news for you today. How many people needed good news on a Sunday? I needed some good news today. Good news for you, you can have as much of Jesus as you prefer. It is all determined by how you seek. How is your search? That's my question. I can feel like I can see it in certain Christians. I can see when people are walking around with heads down and droopy and all the world, everything's crazy. I just feel like at that point we've lost our search. Because if you search, you can't help but be full of Jesus. So at Trove Heights, we like to say it like this. I want to be so full of Jesus that you come around me, I'm just gonna slosh him on you. But I can't slosh Jesus on you if I'm not full of Jesus. And it only happens in the secret place, the quiet place, in your time with Jesus, the first of your day, the first 15. Jeremiah 29:13 says, you will seek me and find me, when? When you seek me with all your heart. All your heart. Sometimes we want to take out the all and just say, when you seek me with your heart. No, all your heart. If you give God all, that gives you access to all that God has for you today. You got to seek him with all. You got to give him all. And then your life will begin to change. Matthew 7:7, it says, ask and it'll be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and it'll be opened unto you. Now, I'm about to give y'all something. You should write this down, put it on your fridge. I don't know where it came from. I'm going to say I did it, okay? It's an acronym, ASK. Ask, seek, knock. A-S-K. Ooh, that's tight, ain't it? Come on, ask. That's an acronym for you. Seriously, it's a progressive nature in that scripture verse. First, you start by asking. Then you go on a journey and you seek, you search. And then you just go, I'm not taking no for an answer. I love how in the Old Testament, you see the angel come down. He's wrestling with Jacob. And Jacob says, I will not let you go until you bless me. I wonder how many of us have stopped before the blessing, stopped before the miracle, stopped before what if we would have stopped praying and fasting on day 20? No, 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 we prayed through. The problem is too many of us pray for. We need to pray through and watch what God can do when you do that. I promise you, it can change your life. Proverbs 8:17, I love those who love me and those who seek me diligently find me. We want to help you find more of Jesus. That's our goal here at Trove Heights. That's the only goal I got. I want to help you find more of Jesus. I want to help you find the treasure of a rich life with Jesus. I had a pastor say once, and this just marked me. He said, God will give you everything you ask for spiritually to the degree that you ask for it. Good news today, you can have as much of Jesus as you want, as much as you prefer. How much do you want? I'm just under the impression that Trove Heights can be a place full of people that are hungry for more of Jesus. I need more of Jesus in my life. And then people tie on to that because they see that passion and that hunger. And it says in scripture that a man's hunger will drive him on. If my hunger is for Jesus, I'm just going to say, come on with me. I'm no better than anybody else. I'm up here doing it because I'm on a journey and I want to take you with me. I want to take you on the journey with us. The more you seek, the more you find. And that leads me to the last point, which is really the end of our vision where we want to help you get to, and that's living a rich life with Jesus. Now, the cool part about that is there's not an arrival. Again, you can have as much of Jesus as you want. We want to help you live rich. And again, back to scripture. I love this. 1 Timothy 6:6. This is in the easy to read version. How many of y'all knew that existed? The easy to read version. Your boy needed that when I gave my life to Jesus, okay? It says, devotion to God is in fact a way for people to be very rich. But notice the verse didn't stay there. It says, but, it's a big but, only if it makes them satisfied with what they have. When we came into this world, we brought nothing, and when we die, we can take nothing out. Your rich life is determined by where your contentment is. It says that in the NIV, it says it this way, now there is great gain in godliness with contentment. When I realize that all I have is Jesus, I realize that I have all that I need. The problem is too many of us lost the magnificence of our salvation somewhere along the journey. And we get in this point and we raised our hand in a church service like this or somewhere, and we said yes to Jesus, but we never moved another inch beyond that. And yes, God can save you and you can go to heaven like that, but I'm under the impression that God's purpose is to give us a rich and satisfying, full and abundant life. But we gotta go on the search to find it. And we wanna help you with that here at Trove Heights. That is our goal, Philippians 4:19. My God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. Whatever you need, God's got it. God's got it, and he will use you to give him glory through your mess. This has been my prayer for Trove Heights. God, I don't know how many people are coming. I don't know what's gonna happen. I don't care. What I care about is that your riches in glory come and fill this place, and then that is a place that other people come to know you, and they see your glory, and they feel your presence and your power. That's our hope. But it starts with being what Paul said in Philippians 4:12. He says, I have learned the secret of being content in any and every situation, whether well-fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or want. I've learned the secret. The secret is Jesus. You don't need anything more than Jesus. You just need more of Jesus. You get more of Jesus, you get more of what he brings. You get more peace, more love, more joy, more community. I am the sum of the people I have around me in my life. Good godly men. I got men on the front row, my dad being one. Every day we just share scriptures and we preach and we're like, somebody better shout right now. We start preaching to each other. I want to get closer to Jesus because I have people around me challenging me and keeping me accountable, and you need that too. So in a couple weeks, we're gonna launch small groups. You need a group. An idle mind is the devil's playground. The last place you need to be is alone with your thoughts. You need to get in a group of people that love you and wanna help you go on this search. That's what we're here for. That's why Trove Heights is here, is to help you go on a journey to search deep. The vision of our church started where the search began. In Matthew 13:44, when I gave my life to Jesus, I read this and it just marked me, and that's where the name came from and the vision and everything. It says this, the kingdom of heaven is like a treasure hidden in a field for years and then accidentally found by a trespasser. The finder is ecstatic, what a find. And then he proceeds to sell everything he owns to raise money and buy that field. He found the treasure. Everybody in this life wants the same thing, all of us. We want love and joy and peace and community, strength, comfort. We want all the things that only come from Jesus, but we look in all the wrong places. And maybe you walked in here today and you've been looking in all the wrong places. That's okay. You found the right place today. Jesus is here in the room. And he's here just for you for this time. And you are not here by accident. And maybe you're hearing me say this and you're like, how do you know all that? Man, you got to say that because you are the pastor. You're the preacher. You're the man of God. You got to say that. No, I know that so well because I know a guy. And this guy, if you knew him, you'd be like, this dude is too far gone, too crazy. There's no way. God can't use him. God can't do anything with his life. This guy was as far away from God as he could be. He grew up in the right environment, family, love, the Word of God, church. But then on graduation night of high school, this guy decided, I'm just going to party for one time. It's just God's biggest day of my life. You understand. I'm going to party one time. And then that one night turned into, let's go on a senior trip, week-long senior trip. He goes on a senior trip. And that just kept compounding and eventually turned into 10 years running from God. Nothing to do with church, nothing to do with good, godly people, all the wrong places, searching high and low for the treasure and everything the world had to offer, money, women, drugs, alcohol, everything the world had to offer. I'm just going to go find it. Only to realize that all that was just empty. Just kept making him more empty, more broken. And then in 2012, that guy had a pain. He had to go to the emergency room. He goes through a surgery. He's going through a drive-thru one day. He gets a call from the doctor, and the doctor says, we wanted to let you know that you have stage 4 cancer. And in that moment, his whole world came crashing down. What do I do? What do we do? He calls his wife, at home with 2 young babies, calls his family. I don't know what's going to happen. I'm scared. I'm fearful. What do I do? And at the end of the day, when you don't know where to turn, you got to turn to where you know to turn. Turn to Jesus. That's what he did. He said, I know where I think miracles might be able to happen. Goes back to church. Says, we're going to go home. Tells his wife, this is about to be hard. We got to go through chemo. We got to go through surgery. It's going to be crazy. We're going to get through it, but we got to go to church. Got to go to church. So they start going to church over and over again. You get around God's people. You get around God. Get around God's people. And eventually, 2013, fast forward, the doctors clear him and say, you're in remission. You can go back to work. You can go back to life as normal. Woo! But he still didn't go all in with Jesus. 1 foot in, 1 foot out. Still going to church, but still seeking the world at the same time. Not giving God his all. But eventually, over time, more and more of Jesus, more and more of the presence of God. June 3rd of 2013, that guy stepped in a church service just like this. Sitting in a seat just like you. In a moment just like this. And he knew, I can't take it anymore. And he knew, I got to go all in. So he ironically made that decision on the way home. And he called his best friend, who was his drug dealer. That's a bad combination, y'all. That was life. He calls his best friend and his drug dealer, Big Billy, I need you to bring me some beer and cigarettes, Budweiser's, Newports. Bring it over. Got something to tell you. Big Billy rolls over there that night. They drank all those beers, smoked all those cigarettes. And he said, what did you want to tell me? He said, I wanted to tell you that today I gave my life to Jesus. And Big Billy said, bro, what kind of church you go to today? What's going on? And he said, no, I wanted you to be my accountability and I wanted you to be my witness that this is the last time I ever drink a sip of alcohol or touch a cigarette or a drug today. I wanted you to be my accountability. And so the next day he woke up and he thought this is what all Christians do and he enrolled into Bible college. He just began to pursue the call that God had on his life. His life was changed. He found the treasure. He began to pursue more of it. Goes through Bible college. 2 years later, he finds himself going on staff at a great church hundreds of miles away. Just whatever it takes to help people find the treasure. Ends up launching campuses and standing on stages, leading people to Jesus, baptizing people, watching people be set free in small groups and find community. And another campus and another campus. God is just doing great work. And then he finds himself moving to start something great for God and do it well so that people can know Jesus. And God radically changed his life and has used him to do all kinds of great things for the kingdom of God. And the way I know that story so well is because that guy is me. That guy is me. And I don't know what you walked in here with today. Maybe you walked in here looking like that guy, but God can change you in a moment and turn you into this guy right here. He can turn you into somebody who's leading people to Jesus and a rich life. God has more for you today. God has more for you today. So much more for you. You don't have to stay in your mess, but it all starts with a decision. I'm going to go on a search, God. I'm going to go on a journey. And that's what we want to help you do today. That old guy, he was a mess, but God, God can do anything. God can do anything, you know, far more than you could ask or imagine. And maybe you're hearing me say that and you're like, man, that's a cool story, but I'm in a mess and I don't want to minimize where you're at. You need Jesus. Jesus is here today. There is nothing that Jesus won't do for you. And it says so in Scripture, Romans 8:31. This is God talking to you today. So what do you think? With God on our side like this, how can we lose? If God didn't hesitate to put everything on the line for you, embracing your condition today, where you are right now, not where you were, where you want to be, where you are right now, he embraced it and exposed himself to the worst by sending his son. Is there anything else he won't gladly and freely do for you? There's nothing that God won't do for you. Whatever you need him to do today, if you need more peace, more joy, more love, more community, God has all that for you today. It's all determined by your search. I love the way he says it in Ephesians 3. He describes it as the inexhaustible riches and generosity of God. We want to help you begin to live a rich life with Jesus, but it starts with how are you dreaming and going on this search to find more and watch it unfold in your life. It has to start somewhere. And maybe you came in like this today, and if you want to know at the foundation, what's the heartbeat of Trove Heights? What's this church really about? This is what this church is about. Somebody needs to hear this today. Let this sink in. If you're having sex before marriage, come to church anyway. If you're a drug addict trying to beat addiction, come to church anyway. If you were out drunk last night, all night, come to church anyway. If you aren't sure what gender you prefer, come to church anyway. If you can't quit that disgusting habit, come to church anyway. Church is a hospital for the broken, the lost, the empty, the confused, the desperate, and the rejected. Every sinner has a future. Every saint has a past. How do we break the chains of addiction and bondage? By prayer. Prayer for you and prayer with you today. There isn't a single person in the four walls of this church right here and right now that doesn't have something that we hate or regret about our past. There's things that I'd never want to admit out loud about myself, but God knows and he loves me and you nonetheless. So whatever you've done, whatever you're doing, whatever you will do, come to church anyway. It might just change your life. And that's our hope for you today. As we close, I just want you to know that God wants you to live a rich and satisfying life. And it all starts with how are you dreaming? How are you searching? And so that's what my invitation is for you here today. I love it. Out of the book of Romans, this is our vision. Paul says, reach out and experience the breadth. Test its length, plumb the depths, rise to the heights, live full lives, full in Jesus. I love how it starts by saying, reach out. Right here, right now, this is your moment to reach out and let Jesus grab your hand and take you on that journey. So if everybody would, heads bowed, eyes closed in this moment, this is your opportunity to reach out. You're one reach away from God changing everything. And you have an opportunity. Your eternity weighs in the balance here in this moment. I don't know what you walked in with. I don't know what background you came from. Maybe you don't believe all the stuff I said or you're trying to figure it out, but I'm telling you the worst that could happen is God could change the rest of your life. And that's what we want to offer you today is a journey to go search deep, find more and live rich. So today, if you know you need Jesus, nobody else needs to tell you. You know. And today, if you need to recommit your life to Jesus, maybe you wandered away at some point, you stopped going to church. God is saying right now, big smile on his face. He's standing at the door saying, come home. Come home. This is a safe place. Come home. If that's you today, at the count of three, I just want you to lift your hand. One, two, three. Nobody looking around. Lift your hand. Lift your hand. Come on. Amen. Yes. Oh, yes. Come on. Yes. 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 Yes, that's what it's all about. If all voices in the room could say this prayer out loud, say, Jesus, today I give you my life. I believe in my heart and I confess with my mouth, you are Savior, you are Lord. I'm gonna live for you for the rest of my days. I give you all the glory, all the honor, all the praise today. In Jesus' name, everybody said, amen, amen, amen. Come on, can we celebrate everybody that just said yes to Jesus? Come on, celebrate them. That's awesome. Woo. Wow. That's what it's all about. That's what we're doing today. That's why we're going to be here every Sunday, because we're going to help people meet Jesus take you on a journey to fall passionately in love with Him. That's the mission of our church. And so listen, if you just said that prayer, you have some next steps. This is the most important part of our service right here, because if we just left you there, we couldn't help you know what all God has for you down the road. We want to give you some next steps. So if everybody in the room could, front to back, you got a connect card when you came in, pull that out, put it in your lap real quick. You can take your phone out if you'd like to do this digitally. We have a way for you to do that. But we want to get your info as much as you're comfortable with us having. We're not going to call you or come to your house. Not going to do anything crazy, but we want to connect you with next steps. We're going to have small groups kicking off in a couple weeks. We want to help get you plugged in there. We want to help you. If you need a Bible, again, grab a Bible on the way out. We have that for you. We're going to start something in 2 weeks called our growth track. We want to help you with that. But this starts by filling out that connect card. So if you said yes to Jesus, you can check the box, I committed my life to Jesus. Or maybe today you said, I'm going to renew that commitment. You can check that box. If you want to be water baptized, you can check that box. Or if you'd like to talk with the pastors, I'd love to talk with you. You can check that box. If you need to check all four, that's cool. Or you can text commit to 94090. Same card will be there digitally for you. But please do us a favor and fill that out. That'll help us be able to guide you along the journey. Because today the journey started. It only gets better, all right? We want to help you begin to search deep. And so go ahead and fill that out. You can drop it in the buckets here in a few minutes on the way out the door for the ushers. Drop that card if you have a physical one. But there's a lot happening around Trove Heights, man. We want you to jump in full force with us. Hopefully today you said, I want to make this my church home. Anybody have fun in church today? I had fun in church today. We want you to have fun in church. So we'd love for you to make this your church home and be a part of it with us. Help build something that I believe God is going to use for many, many years down the road to change a lot of lives. But we'll be a lot better with you than we are without you, okay? I need you in my world. You need me in your world. Let's do it together. You can be a part of our growth check that'll kick off in 2 weeks. That's a two-step process where we want to help you begin to go on that journey. That's how you can get plugged in to our dream team. Where's my dream team in the room? Dream team, and then we got dream team. You can be a part of the dream team. Listen, if you can sing, we need you up here. If you love kids, we need you back there. Let's do this together. Let's build a church. It takes a lot of people, a lot of manpower to do this, but God's provided, and we'd love to have you a part of it. We'll kick that off in 2 weeks. We're gonna help you discover the gifts God put inside of you. And then we're just gonna keep building this thing, man. I'm excited. Listen, next week we're gonna have one service at 10:30 a.m. That'll be where we move from this point on, one service at 10:30 a.m. And we're gonna watch God just build it and grow it. And if there's one thing I know, we're gonna come in here and have some strong worship every week. We're gonna have a good time together. It's gonna be fun. This will be community, and we wanna have you a part of it. So I hope that you make that decision with us. Again, fill out that card. Drop it off on the way out, and our team will take care of you. Let's all go ahead and stand now. We're going to worship as we prepare to leave. We're going to punctuate this service with a strong end and let God know how much we love Him as we roll out today. Before we do that, listen, if this is your first time checking out Trove Heights, this is not for you, but friends and family of Trove Heights, or if you're sitting in here and you know right now, I'm going to make this my church home, then you have an opportunity to sow in financially and help us advance this. We believe that the vision can only advance as fast at the pace of our generosity. And so we want to invite you to be a part of that. We are a no pressure environment. We want you to ask God what you should do. He'll tell you, you listen to Him, okay? Just ask God how you can be a part of helping us advance this thing and propel it forward. I believe He's going to do greater than we can ask or imagine. And together we have an opportunity to propel that. So you can do that one of the few ways on the screen. Drop that in the buckets on the way out. You'll see they got bright yellow buckets. Come on, somebody. They got yellow buckets back there. You can go to troveheights.com/give or text Trove Heights to the number on the screen. And let's worship as we leave today. You can give on the way out. Before we do that, I'm going to pray. Give God your best as we leave here today, all right? Let's give Him our best. God, we love You. Today we thank You for what You've done. We seal this launch Sunday. And we say thank You for showing up. Thank You for all You did. Thank You for all the lives changed, all the salvations. And thank You that from this point on, You will get greater glory in Nashville, Tennessee, in Jesus' mighty name we pray. And everybody said, amen. Come on, let's worship.
Come on, let's seal it with a prayer.